Hello students, today we shall be starting with the main topics concept of resistivity and conductance of unit current electricity and chapter is electric current and Ohm's law page number 260-264. Main objectives of these topics will be resistivity, conductivity, then effect of temperature on resistivity for metals, alloys, semiconductors, and the terms which will be related here they will be resistivity, conductivity and conductance. I hope you have understood the topics which we are going to do today. Now let's start with resistivity. Resistivity is basically resistance only, but it is offered to the conductor having unit length. We can say let it be 1 centimeter and the area would be 1 centimeter square then. So the answer would be resistivity is the resistance offered to the conductor of unit length and unit area of cross section, but it should be at a constant temperature because with the change in temperature resistivity changes. Now what is the unit of resistivity? Ohm, meter, and symbol is rho. Then comes conductivity. Conductivity is nothing but the reciprocal of resistivity. Reciprocal of resistivity is conductivity and its unit is inverse of the unit of this resistivity, ohm inverse, meter inverse. It is noted with sigma. Next one is conductance. Conductance again is the reciprocal of resistance. It is denoted with G and its unit is ohm inverse. Now these topics we have discussed here because the numericals related to this topic are very very important. Now let's shift towards the next topic. Effect of temperature on resistivity. This is a very important topic and we have to do it in detail. Now as we have done the effect of resistance on, effect of temperature on resistance, similarly is that effect of temperature on resistivity. We just have to write here rho instead of writing R. So what answer we will get, it is rho equal to rho naught 1 plus alpha T minus of T naught, and alpha is coming out to be like this. So the definition of this temperature coefficient of resistivity will be, it is the change in resistivity per unit original resistivity per degree rise in temperature. So this is nothing but alpha in terms of resistivity. Now let's come for various metals, non-metals and alloys and all, what is the effect of temperature on this thing. In case of metals, the resistivity increases with the increase in temperature. Okay, we should know that what is the effect. It is resistivity is increasing here, but why is the resistivity increasing? We can understand why. The concept here is this is because with the temperature free electrons get more energy. Now when the temperature is increased, electrons get more energy, and when they get more energy they will collide with each other as they will travel very fast. When they will collide, there will be less time where when they will be relaxed, means the relaxation time will be less, and according to this formula rho is inversely proportional to relaxation time. This topic we have already done in the previous topics. So from here it is concluded that if tau is small, resistivity will be more. So we can conclude here that resistivity increases with the rise in temperature. Now the graph here is like this, means they are directly proportional. With the rise in temperature, resistivity is increasing, so the graph is going straight. Hence this is for the metals. Now let's shift towards the semiconductors. For semiconductors, alpha is negative, means the resistivity decreases with the rise in temperature, and that is also in the exponential form. The exponential graph for resistivity and temperature will be like this, going down. Hence we have concluded here that resistivity decreases with the rise in temperature. For which thing? For semiconductors. Next is our insulators. Insulators, for insulators we have n equal to n naught e ki power minus e over kt. Here e is called as energy gap. Now resistivity depends on the number of free electrons, but we know that in insulators the number of free electrons are very less, hence the resistivity is also less. So we can say that for low temperature n is small for semiconductors and insulators. So the conductivity is small, there is no conductivity, means the electrons are not able to move because there are no free electrons. So if the conductivity is less, means the resistivity is more. So we can say that in case of insulators the resistivity is large. Now let's come to the alloys. In case of alloys, what is the thing? With the rise in temperature, the resistivity of the alloys also increase, but in very small amount as compared to the metals. We can see here in the graph is going straight. That means that the resistivity is increasing with the rise in temperature, but with a very small amount. Now we have done for semiconductors, we have done for insulators, we are going to start with now electrodes. In case of electrodes, as we have seen in our homes, we are using inverters, we have electrodes and they are in liquid form. So the resistivity there decreases with the increase in temperature. Why? This is because viscosity. What is viscosity? We have done in plus one class. Viscosity is nothing but the resistance offered in a liquid form. That decreases. And with the rise in temperature, what happens? The electrons are very free to move from here one place to the another. When the electrons can move from one place to another, that means that their resistivity will decrease. So we can see here the graph is going down. So I hope you have understood for semiconductors, for insulators, for alloys and for electrodes. I hope you have understood the topic. Thank you, students.